Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to share with you how to make this beautiful salad with this Asian dressing. Oh my goodness, this is so good, y'all. And like always, I will put the ingredients, the recipe link, and all the tools that I used for this recipe down in the description box. But if you'd like to see how I make it, stay tuned. So here are the ingredients I used. First is coconut aminos, almond butter, unsweetened and unsalted. Next is heirloom tomatoes. I love heirloom tomatoes because they're just juicier. And this is a greenish red one. They come in different colors. And also you don't have to use an heirloom tomato. You can use whatever kind of tomatoes you have on hand, or you can just leave tomatoes out. Next ingredient for a bit of sweetness are two kiwis. Love kiwis, especially this time of year, because they're in season and they're really sweet and they're not hard. Next is an English cucumber. That's about a half of an English cucumber. Love those cucumbers a little bit better than the other varieties, but you can use whatever type of cucumber you would like. Next, we have a small avocado, some walnuts, some hemp seeds, a couple tablespoons of water. And last but not least is our lettuce varieties. First, we're going to use some Boston lettuce, which is a very tender lettuce. It's also a little sweeter than other lettuces. So if you have not tried Boston lettuce, you should definitely try it. The other lettuce variety that we're going to use is a 50-50 mix, and this is just mixed greens, and it has baby lettuces in it and baby spinach. We're going to start with our mixed greens. As you guys know, I like to cut the greens in small, like ribbon type cuts so that I can add as many greens to the bowl as I possibly can. You don't have to cut your lettuce at all, but the more you cut it, the more you're going to be able to eat. And for this recipe, you can add 3 to 4 handfuls of mixed greens. This salad is also for 2 people. Now we're going to work with our Boston lettuce. The first thing we're going to do is get it prepared so that we can wash it, because you have to wash head lettuce. So we're gonna take out the plug, is what I call it, on the bottom. With Boston lettuce, it's easy to just pull it out. And we're just gonna start slicing it. I'm gonna roughly chop it. I'm not gonna make it really small, just so that it adds a little bit different texture to the salad. You notice the difference between how I cut the mixed greens and how I cut the Boston lettuce head. I'm just adding it to the salad spinner. I absolutely love having a salad spinner because it helps with washing and drying the lettuce really quickly. Now all I'm doing is putting the lid on the salad spinner so that I can get some of the water off. I've already rinsed the lettuce, so I'm just gonna spin it, hit the stop button, take the lid off, lift the basket out, and then drain the water. My sink is right to my right, so I'm putting it back in there. And then I'm gonna do it a second time just to make sure all of the excess water is out. You see how I'm like spinning it really quickly, and I've stopped it. I'm gonna take the lid off again, and then pour that little excess water out. And now all I have to do is just add the lettuce to the bowl. That's it. That was really fast. I wasn't sitting there with towels or paper towels trying to dry the lettuce off. And I'm going to tell you, one of the things that used to deter me from making salad was having to wash and dry the lettuce and having to take all that time. This salad technically took me about less than 15 minutes to make. And like, I think that was really fast. And of course it took me longer to prepare the video, but if I was just making the salad, I know I could have gotten it done in less than 10 minutes. It's that easy. When you get a system down, it's not difficult to make salad. So I'm only going to use half of this large heirloom tomato. I'm going to cut it in half and chop it. I think the inside of heirloom tomatoes looks so interesting and beautiful. So I'm going to only have half of this one. So I'm going to chop it up and put it in a salad. And now I'm gonna take my chopped tomatoes and add them to the salad bowl. I like to make my salads pretty, but you don't have to do it. All you have to do is just dump the vegetables in the bowl if you would like to. Next, we're adding the cucumber. And really, you can use whatever cucumber you like. And as I mentioned before, my favorite are English cucumbers. So use whatever you'd like. If you don't like cucumbers, you can use zucchini instead. What I like most about cucumbers is that they add a crunch to the salad. And the other thing is they are good for your skin, nails, and your hair. So if you're having trouble with those three things or one of those things, adding cucumber is a great thing to do for your life. It will help, and especially drinking cucumber juice. Also, if you all have not seen my juicing ebook, you probably should check it out if you're looking to regrow your hair or to minimize fibroid symptoms. I will put a link above and below for my juicing ebook if you're interested. Next is the little bit of sweetness that we're going to add to the salad. And again, I am going to use my Titan peeler to peel the skin off of the kiwi. I absolutely hate eating kiwi skin. That's one thing you will not see me eating is kiwi skin. So if you don't like kiwi skin and you want an easy way to get it off, the Titan peeler is my choice. See how easy that is? It just grabs hold of the skin and it peels it off easily. And you're not going to cut your fingers off trying to get that skin off. Love the Titan peeler. Now I'm going to cut up the kiwi and I'm going to add it to the salad. There's no special way to cut the kiwi. You cut it any way you'd like. You can make big chunks, small chunks, thin chunks, whatever you would like to do. Also, if you don't like kiwi, you can add whatever kind of fruit you like. You can add strawberries, blueberries, peaches, oranges, whatever you want to the salad. Now we're going to add a very small avocado to the salad. This avocado made the salad taste really, really creamy, like you have a creamy, like ranch dressing on it. You know that texture that you get from eating a creamy dressing? That's what the avocado did for this salad. So I'm just cutting it into cubes and I'm just going to scoop it out and add it to the salad. Next, we're going to add in 1 to 2 tablespoons of hemp seeds and also 1 to 2 tablespoons of walnuts. And these are going to give you your healthy fats, your proteins, and your omega-3 and 6 vitamins. So don't be afraid to use these nuts and seeds in your salad. They also give your salad a crunch, and hemp seeds also give your salad a flavor that is similar to cheese. Now we're going to make the dressing. 1 to 2 tablespoons of almond butter. Just get unsweetened, unsalted almond butter. And you add it to the bowl. Next, we're going to add coconut aminos. And you want to use about 1 to 2 tablespoons of this. But the reason you want to use coconut aminos over soy sauce is because soy is very bad for the body, especially if you're fighting fibroid symptoms. And then you just want to mix that until it's well combined. You'll probably have to add some water to thin it out a little bit, more or less to taste, or how it really depends on how thick you like your dressing. Just keep stirring until it's thinned out and the consistency that you like. Okay, there you have it, this beautiful salad that is fibroid friendly with this Asian dressing that is easy, simple, and delicious. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.